First of all, you want to create a rectangle and a rectangle. I'm going to set it about 40, 41 to get tweaking to how much you want. If you're using an older version of Photoshop, it may not work the same way, so you might have to do it from this bar up here, and you won't be able to continue to customize it as I can from using the latest version. Change the color. I'm going to use red in this case, I'm going to do a YouTube start button. And because I'm trying to do a YouTube button, I'm going to do a triangle on top to mimic the YouTube's simplified logo. Of course, the content can vary based around what you want to have. Next, I'm going to create a gradient, and as I'm pressing Alt Control and clicking between the two layers to lock this one onto this one, and the gradients by pressing G, you can toggle G, Shift G, or just do it using the mouse. Okay, I want to choose the option. Let's go white to transparent. And you want to create it about halfway through the image, roughly. Like that. It's going to wipe it out, but just turn the opacity down to 30%, 40%. I'm doing that by pressing 3 and 4 on the keyboard. It's a quite useful shortcut. Just changes the opacity. This one is unlocked onto this one. Next, I'll create a stroke inside the shape, the main shape. Turn it up a bit. A lot of tweaking, let's get it right. We can make it sort of black, white, or I'm going to make it a similar color to the main block. You can also do that by, of course, selecting using the point select or color picker. I'm going to do is going to switch to gradient. So you've got fill type, color, switch to gradient. Let's pick it from here. Set it down a little bit. This is going to give a bit more 3D effect. Make it pop out a little bit. And switch the angle to 90 or negative 90. So I'm going to have a darker side at the bottom to follow logic of shadows and a lighter side at the top. But it's slightly darker than the central colour. Let's create a very, very subtle bevel. Be really careful with bevels, they look cheesy so easily. Just to help it pop out a bit more, although it's optional really. Okay, next I'm going to go to drop shadow, again very subtle, just to give it a bit of pop. Very sharp shadow would look bad. And I mean, if I was to do a button, I'd probably have the up state be like this. The other state would be darker. Take away the sheen. Take away the stroke. So you see it seems a bit flatter. Take away drop shadow. So you get the impression of the button being pressed down.